floating anywhere we please, holding you tight as I can. You're safe as a honeypot, you always will be, and I'll be right there when we land. You're snuggly woggly, snug as a buggly. You're snuggly safe in my hands. Oh, hello. I'm Pooh, which is short for Winnie the Pooh, which isn't short. I don't think I've seen this treehouse before. And since everyone I know already has a house, why, this one must be yours.
New resident? Why wasn't I notified? Well, gotta get a mailbox in pronto, by dingy. Won't be official till you got a mailbox. Of course, nothing would get done around here if I didn't do everything myself. So don't you worry. Whenever you need anything moved from anywhere to any here, I'll be on the job. Yes, sirree.
This mailbox is missing some something. Why, of course, it needs your name. Might you put it there? You can click on the proper letters to spell out your name on the mailbox. And when you've spelled out your whole name, just grab hold of that green balloon. Then we'll be off to explore the Hundred Acre Wood.
Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Little Bumblebear's Let's Play. I'm Chris Little Bumblebear and I'm back with Winnie the Pooh. This is Winnie the Pooh, get ready to read. I hope you enjoy. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe for more nostalgic gaming. There are playlists in the description box if you want to see more Disney and Winnie the Pooh content, so check those out. I stream on Twitch, feel free to follow my channel, twitch.tv/littlebumblebear. Don't worry, Pooh, we'll get started soon. I also have a Twitter and Instagram you're welcome to follow, and a Discord if you'd like to be in the Discord. Just let me know in the comments down below and I'll get you an invite link. Without further ado, let's begin. Enjoy.
Just grab hold of that green balloon. Then we'll be off to explore the Hundred Acre Wood. K-R-I-S-T-E-N. If you wish, I'll be very happy to show you around the Hundred Acre Wood. Perhaps we shall find some things to make your tree home homier. Wherever our wander takes us, we shall have this special red honeypot. Anytime you would like to know a bit more about what to do, just grab a hold of this special pot. Then I shall tell you all the wonderful things we can do. There are several paths we may take, each as good as the next, none better than the other, since any way one goes with a friend is a good way. Just choose a path and off we'll go. If you're going in, might I come too, in case any stray honey's been left laying about? If we're done in here, I suppose we'll be going. If you're going in, if we're by going neither south nor north, and not in the least bit east, we shall go west. My furry friends play the flute and the fiddle. Now we shall see the tree Tigger goes climbing, even though we all know that Tiggers don't climb trees.
Hey, it's great to see ya! I'm glad you came around. I climbed so high up in this tree, and now I can't climb down. If you can pick the patch, inches for the quote down there. Why, I can get back to the ground by flying through the air. I know that you can help me, and when the quilt is done, I might just bounce back up here, and we'll have some more fun.
Bother. We've just learned a bit of a lesson. Tiggers don't climb trees. Or rather, they climb up all right. It's the coming back down that's a bit sticky. And as you can see, Tigger is now quite stuck. If you will help finish this quilt, Tigger might jump down into it, safe and sound. First thing to do is that which hasn't been done. The first letter of each word seems not to be where it should be. We must find the first letter of each word and bring it from the tree trunk to the quilt. Then we just put it in the empty spot where it belongs. And if you feel a bit uncertain about a word, you might go to the picture to hear what it is. Confidentially, to just you and no one else, I have never known Tigger to climb a tree less than 3 times in a row. Those clothespins will help you keep track of how many quilts you've made for Tigger. W.E.B. Webb.
Falling out of trees is not something Tiggers do best.
P.I.G. Pig.
I don't know which will give out first, me or the branch.
N.U.T. Nut.
If I have to hang here till autumn, I'm gonna fall.
F.A.N. Fan.
Heads up, I'm coming down.
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back into the tree. S.A.W. Saw.
I don't want to complain, but I can't hang around forever.
B.U.G. Bug. Now that word is done. J.A.M. Jam. Most superbly spelled. T.I.E. Tie.
I don't know what to say, except...
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back into the tree. P.I.E. Pie. You've done it. B.O.W. Bow. Just as it should be. L.O.G. Log. Why, that's it. H. H.E.N. Hen.
To you, I'm gonna be safe and sound and down on the ground.
That kite'll come in handy next Wednesday.
To play this game again. To finish this quilt, we must finish M.A.T. Mat. Now that word is done. H.E.N. Hen.
I knew I could count on you.
D-O-G, dog.
Persnickety little fella, isn't he? Sheesh.
T-O-P, top.
Thank you, times 2,111.
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back into the tree. M-A-P, map.
Hey, that's my favorite head you're a-peckin' on.
N-U-T, nut. Most superbly spelled. S-U-N, sun. You've done it. E-G-G, egg.
A super-duper quadruple thanks to you!
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back into the tree. P-I-N, pin, just as it should be. S-A-W, saw. Why, that's it. H-A-T, hat. Now that word is done. B-U-G, bug.
You saved my stripes.
Music to my ears. I'll get this back to your treehouse.
To play this game again, click the pink balloon. These words are all finished, except toward the middle-ish. And that is the letter we must find. S-U-N, sun.
So, it's gonna be like that, is he?
E. P-E-A-P. Most superbly spelled. P. P-I-N, pin.
Falling out of trees is not something Tiggers do best.
I. M-A-P, map.
Heads up, I'm coming down.
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back into the tree. H-E-N, hen. You've done it. F-L-Y, fly.
I don't know which will give out first, me or the branch.
B-O-W, bow, just as it should be. C-A-P, cap.
I don't know what to say, except...
Oh, bother. Tigger bounced back in. T-I-E, tie. Why, that's it. D-O-G, dog.
If I have to hang here till autumn, I'm gonna fall.
B-A-G, bag. Now that word is done. Bag. B-U-G, bug.
Thanks to you, I'm gonna be safe and sound and down underground.
It's plain simple. You need an aeroplane at your treehouse.
To play this game again. Goodbye, Tigger. We shall come again if you need us. If I know Tigger, he just might be up to something again very soon. Two cute caterpillars go into the log.
A is for apple, B is for berries, C is for carrot.
That part must be empty. Now we can drop by my house, although I wonder if I'll be at home at this hour. What a bother. My home is actually quite clean, but the clean is all under the clutter. I had a honey party, you see. Each pot has a spot. I must get the A pot to the A spot, the B pot to B spot, and C to C, you see? Then all the others too. Do you suppose you might help me? Just pick the next pot and put it up on the shelf. As soon as the pots are all back on the shelf, in alphabetical order, we shall be done. A.
B.
C.
C.
D.
D.
Precisely. F.
F.
G.
G.
H.
H.
I.
I.
J.
J.
Super superb. K.
K.
L.
M.
N.
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 O.
O.
Absolutely. P.
P.
Q.
Q.
R.
S.
S.
T.
T.
Be dazzling. U. V.
V.
W.
W.
X.
X.
Y.
Y.
Extra out of the ordinary. Z.
Z.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. U, R, S, T, U, V. W, X, Y, and Z. Now you know your ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Perfect, as it shall stay. Until supper, anyway.
Say, for cleaning like this, you deserve a thanks, and you're welcome, Matt. I'll get it back to your treehouse.
To play this game again, I must get each pot back in place, beginning with A, then B, then C, then whatever, followed by whichever, and the next, you see.
A.
B.
C.
D.
E.
Positively proper.
J. K.
L. M.
N. O.
So.
P.
How very smart of you.
Z.
Every smackerel in order.
Hmm, nice. Job like this deserves a reward. I'll just lug this rug back to your treehouse.
To play this... I'm trying to get these parts put back in a more ABC-ish way.
A.
B.
C.
D.
E.
Pause.
H.
marvelsome.
The
beautiful. Shall we celebrate with some yum, honey?
The place will be spick and span once we get this flag out of here and back to your treehouse.
To play this game again, click. If again the parts get jumbly, might I ask very humbly if you'll come back to help? We shall make a friendly visit to see a friendly piglet.
Oh, hello. I was about to straighten my cabinet. A very big job for a very small animal. Perhaps you might help. If you might open a cabinet door, you'll find a plate with a big letter and a little letter. Then open another door and try to find a plate that looks exactly the same, with exactly the same letters on it. I have 5 sets of dishes to sort. We can keep track by looking at those leaves at the bottom of the cabinet. When they're all filled in, we'll be all done. V. Q. V. V. F. F. Q. Q. Simply superb. T. M. T. T. S. M. 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 S. S. Oh, my, my, my! A. A. H. E. H. H. E. E. Exactly! B. O. B. B. I. O. I. I. O. O. Oh, my, my, my! P. Z. U. U. P. P. Z. Z. I'm so glad you've come to the Hundred Acre Wood.
Super duper! And the pinwheel's gonna look super too, back at your treehouse.
To play this game,
try to find a plate that looks exactly the same, with exactly the same letters on it. D. D. J. Y. 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 J. J. Yes, indeed. C. N. L. C. 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 L. L. N. N. Oh, I am impressed. G. W. X, W, X, X, G, G. Precisely. E, E, R, R, K, K, most magnificent. Z, M, Y, Y, Z, Z, M, M, thank you very much indeed.
Go on, won't even know I'm here. Just let me grab the top for your treehouse.
To play this game.
Do you suppose you might help me match these little letter cups with the big letter saucers? B. P. B. B. O. U. F. L. F. F. U. U. P. L. 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 O. P. 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 O. O. Simply superb. C. S. X. G. S. C. I. S. S. C. C. Q, Q, G, A, X, A, 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 X, X, G, G, wonderful. K, T, R, V, R, R, T, V, T, T, V, V, W, J, K, K, J, J, W, W, very smart indeed. N, N. Z. M. I. D. D. Z. H. I. H. H. M. Z. Simply superb. T. R. L. G. L. L. R. R. G. G. P. J. P. P. J. J. T. T. It's never looked nicer, thanks to you.
A treehouse just isn't a tree home without a yo-yo.
To play this game again.
If my cabinets become muddled again, I hope you'll come back. A small animal can always use the help of a helpful friend.
Now we'll head in a due northerly direction. X. Tigger slides down the hill. Now to the sandy pit for a fine visit with Roo, and you, and Pooh too. That's me.
It's a beautiful day for us to play, but my other friends aren't around. I have an idea. Let's pretend with these friends many sand I found. You can give them a ball or a drum to beat. There's so many things they can do. It's so much fun to make believe. So let's pretend me and you.
As you see, Roo's come to the sandy pit to play with his friends, but his friends are too busy, which is why Tigger made him some friends from sand. Perhaps you and Roo together might pretend up some wonderful fun. If first you'll pick a friend to play with, then something from the sand, you and Roo can pretend the rest. I've played Let's Pretend with Roo before. Little Roo always pretends at least 5 times in a row. Let's keep track of how many times we pretend with these red flowers.
Tigger plays a trombone. Piglet beats a drum. Eeyore plays a tambourine. Tigger plays a tambourine. Piglet beats a drum.
Perhaps you might choose a friend and something from the...
Eeyore plays a trombone. Mm-hmm.
When it came to pretending, you and Roo sure knew what to do.
Of course, your treehouse has to have a boomerang. If you can't remember how to use it, don't worry. It'll come back to you.
To play this game again. If you pick a friend, then some sort of some... Perhaps you...
Tigger plays with the round paddle. Piglet plays with the orange basketball. Eeyore plays with the square paddle. Piglet plays with the striped basketball. Tigger plays with the orange basketball.
You're a good friend to help Roo pretend.
Well, what a blockhead I'd be if I didn't get these back to your treehouse.
To play this game again, click the pink balloon. To play this game at the next level, click the orange balloon. To go back to the woods and find something else to do, click the light blue balloon. If you'll pick a friend, then something from the sand, I'm sure you and Roo can imagine up some grand fun.
Tigger eats one scoop of chocolate ice cream. Piglet eats two scoops of strawberry ice cream. Eeyore drinks two glasses of grape juice. Piglet drinks one glass of orange juice. Tigger eats two scoops of strawberry ice cream.
You're a good friend to help Roo pretend.
Bet if I pulled some strings, I could get this puppet back to your treehouse for you.
To play this game again. Goodbye, Roo. We've had fun pretending with you.
This letter to Roo is from someone whose name starts with an O. O is for owl.
Now we will get a better look at this book, which I believe belongs to Eeyore, although I cannot say for certain.
Another blustery day in the Hundred Acre Wood. I started to read, it didn't work out like it should. My book has been tattered, the pages all are scattered. Please help me put them back together if you could. Please help me put them back together if you could. Hello. Found a nice book for a welcome gift. Of course, the wind tore it to shreds. Figures. If you find the picture to go with the word, maybe we can piece the page back together. Won't know till we try. Rainbow. Violin.
Remarkable.
octopus. Carrot.
How grand!
Ice. Elephant.
Grand going.
Moon. Worms.
Well done.
Zebra. Hat.
Just as it should be.
Bee. Quail.
Right as can be.
Flower. Apple.
I think you're right.
Umbrella. Star.
Just as it should be.
Yam. Xylophone.
Look at that.
Leaf.
Grand going.
Keys. Goat.
Splendidly done.
Nest. Tomato.
Super superb.
Jar.
Thank you. wondrous.
Thanks. You'd never know it was broken.
All right, let's get this baby out of here. This is a big job. So when I heave, everybody, ho. Count of three. One, two, three.
To play this game again, click the pink balloon.
Another blustery day in the Hundred Acre Wood. I started to read, it didn't work out like it should. My book has been tattered, the pages all are scattered. Please help me put them back together if you could. Please help me put them back together if you could. If you find the picture to go with the sentence, maybe we can fix the page. Pooh writes. Pooh yawns.
So it is.
The spider winks. Pooh laughs.
Look at that.
The snowman melts. The fish swims.
Remarkable.
Pooh walks. The octopus juggles.
A very grand job.
The worms swing. Pooh paints.
Super superb.
The elephant sniffs. Pooh sails.
So it is.
There. Good as new.
Alrighty, let's get this thingy to the treehouse. Everybody hook your cable to the whatchamacallit. Look lively. Lift with your legs. Ready, set, go! Oh, my aching back.
To play this game again, click.
Another blustery day in the Hundred Acre Wood. If you find the picture to go with the sentence, maybe we can patch the... Pooh rides in a boat. Pooh eats the corn on the cob.
Oh, my.
Pooh waters the plant. Elephant sniffs the peanut.
Precisely the one.
Pooh goes fishing. Piglet blows the pinwheel.
Super superb.
The lizard crawls out of the bucket. Pooh plays golf.
Look at that.
Pooh floats on a balloon. Piglet is sitting in the nest.
Grand going.
The octopus juggles 8 apples. Starfish hugs the rock.
Well done.
Thanks. Forever indebted to ya.
Yes, sirree. We'll get this back to the treehouse. Get your widget on that beam and string that rope under that whatchamacallit. All right. Get yourselves in gear. You got a 6-inch clearance on your starboard. Careful now. Easy. And here we go. I think I strained a quadricep.
To play this game again.
Come back any day, especially a windy day.
Now we shall drop by to stop in and pop in on our good friend Rabbit.
Wait till I say go! It's totally fantastical and magical and grand!
Yes, but it doesn't make the signs just right.
We need a helping hand. I guess some of the letters look like a bunch of spots.
They do.
We're so glad that you are here to help connect the dots. It's great to have a friend like you to help connect the dots.
Yo, hello. I'm trying to make signs so I can get everything organized, but Tigger's contraption isn't working. The letters keep coming out all discombobulated. Oh, perhaps you might help me finish them up, Well, since the machine didn't finish the letter, maybe you can. Pick a color, then draw the letter. Oh, dear, dear, dear. We just got to get all...
Now let's click on...
N. My sign says, look, Pan.
Hmm.
sheep blows!
Why?
Splendid?
Why? Oh, now the sign says yes. B. Not bad at all.
The puzzle look. G. What a G.
Mind your P's and Q's. That is a B. Oh, my sign. Bed.
Wait till I say go.
Not
go to the dog. At the
not A. Oh, my, it says P.
Hold on to your hat wrap.
C. C. Oh, look, my sign says cap.
Such style, such flair, such skill and whatnot.
And our friend's good, too.
There she blows!
S.
That's the best C I ever seen, saw, looked at.
No, Tigger, I think that C is an S, you see. Oh, my sign says six.
Wait till I say go.
R. No.
Let's click.
R. Oh, my sign says rug.
Wait till I say go.
Q. Not.
That's a splendid.
Q.
Rabbit sure needs this Q sign, because he's always so busy minding his P's and Q's.
Q.
I say go.
D. Not bad at
Look at that E.
Oh, dear Tigger, that is a D. Oh, my sign, dog.
Ready, set, and rabbit, go.
P. Now let's see, this spells map. My.
Wait till I say go.
You.
Splendid.
You. Oh, look. My sign says hug.
Let's click. You dotted all the I's on that L.
But Tigger, that's an F. Now the sign says fly.
TTFN.
Which spells what?
Doesn't spell anything. No. Wait till I say go. Now let's go.
M. My sign. Mug.
One for the bunny, two for the crow, three to get ready, 'cause here we go.
Yum yum, this spells pie.
Hold on to your hat, Rex.
V.
That's it. let's click on... That's the bestest C I ever seen, saw, looked at.
Oh, Tigger, I think that C is a V, you see. Well, now the sign says Ivy.
Ready, set, and rabbit, go!
Not T. Now the sign says two.
Ready, set. And rabbit, go!
Z.
Go to the dog. Splendiferous.
I have to. Z. Oh, look, my sign, zag.
There she blows.
H.
Gee, what a Z.
Mind your P's and Q's. That is an H. Oh my, it says hen.
One for the bunny, two for the crow, three to get ready, cause here we go.
J. J. Oh, this spells jar.
On the count of three. Three!
X.
No.
X. Oh, my sign says six.
Wait till I say.
E.
Go to the dock.
No.
You dotted all the I's on that V.
But Tigger, that's an E. Oh, now the sign says pet.
There she blows!
W?
now let...
Ick. A W? Oh, look there. My sign says paw.
Hold on to your hat, Rex. The puther look.
Oh. Oh, it says one.
One for the bunny, two for the crow, three to get ready, cause here we go.
G.
Let's click on... That's the best C I ever seen, saw, looked at.
Tigger, I think that C is a G, you see. Oh, look, my sign now says gem.
Ready, set, and rabbit, go!
K.
Fat.
K. You did it! My sign! Sky!
Absolutely superbulous!
That means good, doesn't it? Not bad at all.
Let's click on the...
Fantastic!
L. You know, this spells log. Thank you. You did what that machine couldn't.
Aw, it was just getting warmed up.
Well, when it comes to making music, you sure can't beat a drum. I'll take her back to your treehouse.
To play this game again.
Wait till I say go.
This machine was no help. But you can help by picking a color and drawing the letter. You just start right here and then go from dot to dot, okay? M. Not.
Let's click on the...
Oh. M. Now the sign says Matt.
One for the bunny, two for the crow, three to get ready, cause here we go.
D. D. Oh, my sign, dog.
TTFN.
Which spells what?
Doesn't spell anything, but it stands for ta-ta for now.
Now we shall head in a rather eastish direction. To Owl's house we go. A very wise choice.
Welcome, welcome. Just in time for my poetry recital. Today I'll be reading from Owl's book of poems, written, compiled, created, arranged, and composed entirely by myself.
Ahem, and music by yours truly.
Send a letter in the mail if you find cheese.
Oh, bother. Howell's rhymes do not ever rhyme. Would you find or write something to make the rhyme rhyme? Then move it over to Owl's music sheet. To hear it will be quite a treat.
There will be 5 poems on the program. Please don't fall behind. Those musical notes on the piano will help you keep track. Send a letter in the mail if you find Eeyore's tail.
That time, we got him rhyme.
Rabbit is dressed, and that is that. On his feet are shoes, on his head is a marshmallows. Rabbit is dressed, and that is that. On his feet are shoes, on his head is a hat.
What a miracle! You made it lyrical!
Eeyore said he saw a rat playing with Roo's baseball sink. Eeyore said he saw a rat playing with Roo's baseball bat.
You took the pathetical and made it poetical.
With just a little bit of luck, Roo will find his yellow plate. With just a little bit of luck, Roo will find his yellow duck.
That time, we got him rhyme.
Rabbit was thirsty, goodness me. He drank half a pot of candle. Rabbit was thirsty, goodness me. He drank half a pot of tea.
TTFN, ta-ta for now.
Hold the phone! It's a xylophone. Let's get her on back to your treehouse.
To play this game again, click the pink balloon to play.
What could be better than writing a hat?
Only.
What what could be better than writing a letter?
Those rhymes were rhyming frightful till you made them rhyming rightful.
Piglet's cup, I think, is in the chair. Piglet's cup, I think, is in the sink.
You deserve 12 rubies and a big old diamond for taking those lines and making them rhyming.
Piglet is oh so shy. He'd never wear a pink tree. Piglet is oh so shy. He'd never wear a pink bow tie.
You're a poet, and now you know it.
Rabbit, poor fellow, is torn. Cut cabbage or harvest hummingbird. Rabbit, poor fellow, is torn. Cut cabbage or harvest corn.
You're a poet, and now you know it.
What Tigger likes best of all is bouncing like a suit. Or ball. What Tigger likes best of all is bouncing like a ball.
TTFN, ta-ta for now.
According to my calculations, you need this back at your treehouse.
To play this game again, click the pink.
Eeyore hasn't socks to lose. Eeyore hasn't any towel.
I'm sorry to say, these poems aren't too poemish. Would you be so kind to think in your mind of a word that makes this rhyme? Even I can do it.
Eeyore hasn't socks to lose. Eeyore hasn't any shoes.
Those rhymes were rhyming frightful till you made them rhyming rightful.
Tiggers do not care for peas. Perhaps they'd like a piece of key. Tiggers do not care for peas. Perhaps they'd like a piece of cheese.
Not a minute too soon. You got them in tune.
Piglet and Pooh are always together. They went on a walk and found a daisy. Piglet and Pooh are always together. They went on a walk and found a feather.
What a miracle! You made it lyrical!
A bath for owl? Quick, get a tree! A bath for owl? Quick, get a towel.
You took the pathetical and made it poetical.
Poor little piglet almost fell down into the rock. Poor little piglet almost fell down into the wishing well. TTFN, ta-ta for now.
I gotta stop fiddling around and get this guitar back to your treehouse.
To play this game again.
Shh, a sleeping snake.
Well, a laughing ladybug. I think that is an H. The drawbridge goes up. Look, there's a crying crab. No.
When Detective Tigger tells a story about a honey jar that's missing, you can solve the crime every time. All you have to do is listen, 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 shh, listen. So, you want to solve mystifying mysteries? First, we gotta recreate the scene of some baffling old cases of mine. Here's how to solve them the Detective Tigger way. I'm gonna read from my detective notes, and you just listen to what I say. Then you get to use these official detective thingamadoodles and move them onto this big board when I say to. When we reach the end of the case, I'll ask you the solution to the mystery, and you click on the right thingamagiggy. Not just anybody can be a detective, you know. Gotta pass the test. Listen to five of my most famous cases. Every time you finish a case, you get a star on the edge of the board there. Get all five stars, and you qualify for your very own detective license. The case of the very crowded tree, in which I, Defective Tigger, had to detect who was stuck in the tree, so Val could rescue him. Rue hopped right on up to the tip-top tip of a big, tall tree. Put little Rue on the board. Piglet climbed up with him. Move little Piglet to the big board. Absolutely super! Of course, Pooh was up there too, you know. Now move Pooh over too. Then Rue jumped down to the ground. Now slide Rue down to the bottom of the board. Electrifying, detectifying. An old Pooh boy got himself down too. Okie dokie, now move Pooh with Rue, would you? Now your detectable question, who was stuck up in the tree? Superbicle! Little Piglet was left up there all by his very small little pink self. Which is too bad, because getting out of a tree is as easy as falling off a log. The case of the confuzzled Happy Thursday presents, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to determine who gave what to whom and why, and what did Piglet give to Rabbit? Little Piglet was at his house. Go on, and move Piglet over. Pooh Boy was there, too. Put Pooh on the board there. Definitely. So with Old Long Ears, bring Rabbit on over. Piglet wished them all a happy Thursday and gave Rabbit a fancy old scarf. Take the scarf on over to Rabbit. Absolutely super! He gave Pooh Bear a balloon. Hoo-hoo! What say you slide a balloon on over to Pooh Boy? Maybe it's some other kind of other one. Go to my detectifying notepad anytime you want. He gave Pooh Bear a balloon. Hoo-hoo! What say you slide a balloon on over to Pooh Boy?
balloon. Now, your detective in question. What did my little piglet pal give to Rabbit? Mittens. That's it. You detected that Piglet gave Longears a scarf to keep his long old ears warm. The case of the Roman red shirt, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detectify who got Rabbit's red shirt. Bunny Boy was doing his dirty laundering out by the clothesline. You can put Rabbit onto the big board, if you will. Must be some other sort of somewhere. Bunny Boy was doing his dirty laundering out by the clothesline. You can put Rabbit onto the big board, if you will. Mrs. Kanga hopped out and stopped by to help him. Hop Kanga on out there. Perfectly perfecto. She had a blue shirt with her. Go on and give Kanga the blue shirt. Pooh Bear was helping, of course. Put Pooh on out there. Perfectly perfecto. Pooh Boy had a red shirt with him. Give Pooh Bear the red shirt. Kanga put the bluer one on the clothesline. Go ahead, hang the blue shirt up there. Fantastical. Now for your detective question. Who has Rabbit's red shirt? Good detecting! Pooh Boy had it! But that's okay, because Pooh will give you the shirt off his back any old day. The case of the borrowed brownish book, in which I, dedicated Detective Tigger, had to detect who borrowed Owl's book. Owl was sitting in his sitting chair, just sitting by the table. Okay, put Owl on the big board. There was a mysterious brownish book on the table. Now, put a brown book on there, will ya? You're no defective detective. Piglet dropped by for a visit. Move Piglet onto the board. Piglet borrowed the brownish book from Owl. Go on and give Piglet the brown book. Definitely. Then Mrs. Kanga hopped in. You can bring Kanga over for a visit. Now for your detectorizing question. Who borrowed Owl's brownish book? You did it. Hoo-hoo! Piglet borrowed the brown book. You solved the mystery of history. The case of the simply single stick, in which I, detectifying Tigger, had to detect who had the one stick for playing Pooh sticks. One fine day, Pooh was out on the bridge, bringing old Pooh Boy onto the big board. Piglet was on the bridge, too. Now move Piglet to the bridge. Owl was on the bridge, too. Now move Owl to the board. Pooh had a piney cone. Give old Pooh Boy a piney cone to hold. Delicious detecting. Owl had a beautiful daffodilical flower. Go ahead and give Owl a flower. Piglet had a stick. Go ahead and give Piglet a stick. As right can be. Now your detectable question. Who had the stick for playing Pooh sticks? That's right. Piglet had it. And that's nothing to shake a stick at. Case closed.
Well, it's clear to me. Every good detective needs a magnifying glass. Let's get her back to your treehouse.
On account of your remarkable ability to listen to clues and solve the bafflingest cases, I award you this officious Tigger Detectifying License. to play this game.
Mysterious mystery number 697. The case of the unknown gift giver, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detect who gave Rabbit a new hat so he could send him a thank you note. Rabbit was at home having his birthday day. He does it every year. Move him on over. Presently, Mrs. Kanga came by to present a present. Bring her on in. Definitely. Kanga brought Rabbit a hat for his head. Go on and put it on the board. Then Roo hopped in. Bring him in there. Rabbit. Perfectly perfecto. Roo brought a pail for Rabbit. Put that on the board next. Now your detective in question. Who gave Bunny Boy the hat for his head? You're smarter than smart, and nearly as smart as me. Kanga gave him the hat for his head. Mysteriously mystifying mystery number 123. The case of the vanishing vegetables, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detect who got no vegetable, and thanks for helping with Rabbit's gardening. Can you imagine? Old Rabbit was in the garden. Well, move him on over there. Pooh Boy was helping out. Well, bring him to the board, too.
Rabbit.
So was Kanga. Hop her on over there, too. There was a carrot in Rabbit's wheelbarrow. Put it on the board now. Delicious detecting. Rabbit gave a carrot to Kanga as a thank you for her helping. Go on and give it. Now for your detectable question. Who helped old long ears but didn't get a vegetable? Super duper detectin'. Pooh didn't get a smackerel of anything for helping Rabbit. Mystifying mystery number 544. The case of the perplexing pinwheel, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detectify who was playing with what, so I'd know who to ask for the missing pinwheel. Roo was playing at home. Move him on over. Little Roo was playing with his little Topperoo. Moving on the board, will ya? Unbelievable! Little Piglet came to play with Little Roo. Move him into the scene next. Piglet was playing with a pinwheel. Put that on the board, please. Absolutely super! Tigger, who is me, came too to play with Roo. Bring him on over. Tigger, I, asked Piglet very kindly if I could please play with the pinity wheel, and Piglet said, why, yes, of course, that he would share. Move the pinwheel over to the little me. I detect a genius at work. Now your detectable question. Who was the last one to play with the pinwheelie? Not quite, but go to my detectifying. Now your detectable question. Who was the last one to play with the pinwheelie? Tigger. Absolutely. Tigger was the last one to play with the pinwheelie. I was. Well, if you say so. Hey, that board looks nice, especially with me up there. The case of the unknown kite flyer, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detect who got to fly the kite first, so Kanga would know who had already had a turn. Pooh got in line to fly the kite. Move him to the board. Go to my... Eeyore came too. Move him to the board next.
Tigger, who is me, wanted to fly the kite too, so I bounced to the front of the line. Move that great guy to the board next. Tigger, you know me, realized it wasn't fair to jump ahead of the others who were waiting in line, so I rebounced to the back of the line. So send Tigger, you know me, to the end of the line. I detect a genius at work. Pooh Boy got hungry and left to go get some honey. What a surprise. Move him back to the small board. No. Go to... Then little bitty Piglet got in line to fly the kite. Line him up on the big board, would you? Definitely. Now for your detectable question. Who do you think was first to fly the kite? Unbelievable! You figured out it was Eeyore who got to fly the kite first. Bet he must have been happy, at least until his kite got stuck in a tree. Poor guy. And now the mystery of the mixed-up mittens, in which I, Detecting Detective Tigger, had to figure out which mittens were Piglet's. Piglet was getting dressed for exploring the northerly pole. Move him on the board. Piglet's red mittens were on the table. Put them on over there. Absolutely super. Pooh Boy came over. Better move him on the board, too. Pooh put his blue mittens on the table. Put them on over there. Electrifying, detectifying. Gopher popped in, too. Bring him on over. Gopher put his green mittens on the table. Put them on over there. Delicious detecting. Now your detecting question. Which colors was the mittens Piglet put on the table? Congratulations. Piglet's mittens were a reddish shade of red. Congratulations.
Say, no self-respecting detective should be without some fingerprint powder.
For your amazing ability to put puzzling pieces together and solve unsolvable cases, I give you this Tigger Detectifying License. It's made out of genuine imitation rawhide paper. To play this game of... So, you want to solve mystifying mysteries? First, we gotta recreate the scene of some baffling old cases of mine. Here's how to solve them the Detective Tigger way. I'm gonna read from my detective notes, and you just listen to what I say. Then you get to use these official detective thingamadoodles and move them onto this big board when I say to. When we reach the end of the case, I'll ask you the solution to the mystery, and you click on the right thingamagiggy. Not just anybody can be a detective, you know. Gotta pass the test. Listen to five of my most famous cases. Every time you finish a case, you get a star on the edge of the board there. Get all five stars, and you qualify for your very own detective license. The case of Not Enough Nightcaps, in which I, Chief Detective Tigger, had to figure out whose head got cold from not having a nighty cap on. Pooh had a slumber party. Both Pooh and Piglet were at Pooh's house. Put Pooh and Piglet on the board. Eeyore and Roo came to the party, too. Move Eeyore and Roo there, too, will ya? Pooh Boy put his nighty cap on. Go on and give it to him. Piglet and Eeyore put nightcaps on, too. Give Piglet and Eeyore nightcaps now. It is perfection of detection. Now your detectable question. Whose head was getting coldest of all? Fantastico! Little Roo was freezing his ears off. The case of the squeakity clean bath, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to detectify who dried off Roo after his bath. It was nighty-night time one evening when Roo Boy was in the washing tub. Plunk him onto the board, won't ya? Mrs. Kanga was there helping him bathe. Bring her on over, too. Tigger, who was me, was there too, waiting for his turn to bathe. Yuck! Move the Tigger, who was me, onto the board, would ya? Roo was holding on to a little toy boat and a little rubber ducky. Move those little thingies onto the big board. Tigger. Definitely! Kanga was using the sudsy soap. Go ahead and put the soap on the boardy, please. And when little Roo's bathing was finished, I, Tigger, grabbed the towel. Go ahead and slide the towel to the board. Unbelievable! Now your detectable question. Who dried off Roo after his bath? Yep. You're unbelievable. You made this board look so detectable. You detected it was Detective Tigger, who is me, who dried off little Roo with the towel. The case of the ever-growing garden, in which I, Detectable Tigger, had to detect who helped Bunny Boy with his garden. Rabbit was out gardening in the garden with a shovel. Put Rabbit and the shovel on the board. Owl was up a tree, reading a book. Now put Owl up there with something to read, if you will. Perfectly perfecto. Piglet came over and gave Rabbit a pack of seeds. Bring Piglet and the seeds to the board, please. Pooh and Roo came by to say hi. Bring both Pooh and Roo to the scene. Now for your defective question. Who was helping Rabbit in the garden? That's it! Piglet had the seeds, so he was the helpful helper with the helping hand. The case of the dangerous dessert, in which I, Detectable Tigger, had to detect who ate too much cake at Rabbit's house. Rabbit and Pooh were busy sitting in Rabbit's house. Get Rabbit and Pooh set up there, will ya? Roo, Eeyore, and Gopher dropped by too. Bring little Roo, Eeyore, and Gopher to the board. Perfectly perfecto. Pooh and Gopher had a littlest piece of cake. Move the smallest piece of cake on the board next, will ya? Eeyore had a medium-sized piece and littlest glass of milk. Go on and put the medium piece of cake and little glass of milk on the board, please. Electrifying, detectifying. Little Roo had a big old whopping hunk of chunk of cake. Put that large piece of cake on the board. Now your detective's question. Whose tummy was aching from too much caking? That's right, Roo. It was Roo who ate too much cake. Boy, was it a piece of cake for you to figure out. The case of the magically appearing pictures, in which I, Detective Tigger, had to figure out who drew the pictures on Mrs. Kanga's wall. One sunny sort of Sunday, Mrs. Kanga was sweeping out her kitchen with a broom. Get her on over there with the broom, if you will. Roo and Piglet were playing on the floor. Set Roo and Piglet on the board. Absolutely super! Pooh and Eeyore were there too, you know. Get Pooh and Eeyore on there. Piglet had a book, and little Roo had a crayon. Okie doke, let's get a book over to Piglet and a crayon over to Roo. You're no defective detective. Pooh had a pinwheelie, and Eeyore had a busted balloon. You can give the pinwheel to Pooh and a busted balloon to Eeyore. Now your detective question. Who would have drawn the crayon pictures on the wall?
Broken balloon.
Not quite. Go to my detective. Now your detective question. Who would have drawn the crayon pictures on the wall? Not quite, but... Roo-droo, that's who, and you knew.
Yep, there's one thing a detective really needs. It's a good bubble pipe. Yep, I'll just get this back to your treehouse.
In consideration of your superbical skills at solving mysterious mysteries and cracking confusing cases, I hereby award you with this official Tigger detectifying license.
To play this game again.
Come back anytime you want to crack up some more cases.
Now to see our bouncy friend Tigger and his bouncy jacks in their boxes.
Presenting my brand spanking new Tiggerific invention, Tiggers Jack in the Boxies. But not just any old Jack in the Boxies. Each one sounds like a different letter. Only I forgot to figure which letter matches what sound. Say, if you help me, we can be co-inventing partners. Why don't you crank the handle on these boxes to hear what sound it makes, then show me what letter goes with it? I've got lots of these jack-in-the-boxes to label. 4 sets by my calculations. So, let's use those marks in the dirt to keep track of how many we got to do. The vegetables. Juggler. Wa. Watermelon. Absolutely. Kettle. Popcorn. La 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 la. Lamb. Fantabuloso. Z. Zipper. Na. Numbers. Du. D. Duh. Ducky. Ba 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 boo. B. B. Bubbles. R, R, rainbow. S. S, S, socks. It was impossible, but you did it any. Look out below. Here she comes.
You're gonna go cuckoo over the clock when you see it back in your treehouse.
To play this game again, click the pink balloon.
S. 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 Soap. M. Monkey.
La 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 la.
L la lollipop. K k kettle. Absolutely. X. 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 X
marks the spot.
Violin. P. P. Peas in a pod.
Z. 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 Z.
Z. Z. Zipper. Fantabuloso.
K.
C. K. Cup.
D.
D. D. Ducky.
Na.
Net.
G.
G. G. Gift.
G.
J. J. Juggler. Ba 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 ba.
R,
R, rainbow.
W.
W, watermelon. Why, you just did the undoable. Look out below. Here she comes.
A jack in the box is worth two in the bush. I'll haul it back to your treehouse.
To play this game again.
Why don't you crank the handle on these boxes to hear what sound it makes, then show me what letter goes with it? Oh, I have a little secret. Some of my jack-in-the-boxies make funny blendy sounds. That's when two different letters get together to make one big sound, like the letter CH make a CH sound. Glug, 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 glug. G-L, gl, globe. Acrobat. M. Elephant. M. Monkey. Keg. Super superbiful. K. K. Kettle. Bra 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 bra. B-R, br, brush. F-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f- F. F. Fish. Cra 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 cra. CR. Cr. Crab. Z. Zizzy. 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 Z. 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 Zipper. Congratulations. Qua. 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 Q, qu, question mark? G, 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 g. G, j, giraffe. Woo-hoo. V, 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 v. Violin. Sha 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 sha. S H sh shell. Wha 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 wha. W. Woo. Woodpecker. That's Mr. One. Doggy. Cha 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 cha. CH ch cherries. Yeah. Why, you yak. H, horsey. Tra 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 tra. T-R, tr, tree. I thank you, and re-thank you. Look out below, here she comes.
Well, I'd be off my rocker to pass this up. Let me get it back to your treehouse.
To play this game again.
To you.
Now, we shall pay a visit to a very good friend, such as yourself. I'm quite certain Tigger paid a visit again. Let's see what new surprise he left inside your treehouse. If you're going in, might I come too, in case any stray honey's been left laying about? Just open up your contraption to see what Tigger put there that wasn't there before. Halfway down the stairs is a stair where I sit. There isn't any other stair quite like it. I'm not at the bottom. I'm not at the top. So this is the stair where I always stop. Halfway up the stairs isn't up and isn't down. It isn't in the nursery. It isn't in the town. And all sorts of funny thoughts run round my head. It isn't really anywhere. It's somewhere else instead. Ernest was an elephant, a great big fellow. Leonard was a lion with a 6-foot tail. George was a goat, and his beard was yellow, and James was a very small snail. Leonard had a stall, and a great big strong one. Ernest had a manger, and its walls were thick. George found a pen, but I think it was the wrong one, and James sat down on a brick. Ernest started trumpeting and cracked his manger. Leonard started roaring and shivered his stall. James gave the huffle of a snail in danger, and nobody heard him at all. Ernest started trumpeting and raised such a rumpus. Leonard started roaring and trying to kick. James went a journey with the goat's new compass, and he reached the end of his brick. Ernest was an elephant and very well intentioned. Leonard was a lion with a brave new tail. George was a goat, as I think I have mentioned. But James was only a snail. These are my 2 drops of rain, waiting on the window pane. I am waiting here to see which the winning one will be. Both of them have different names. One is John and one is James. All the best and all the worst comes from which of them is first. James has just begun to ooze. He's the one I want to lose. John is waiting to begin. He's the one I want to win. James is going slowly on. Something sort of sticks to John. John is moving off at last. James is going pretty fast. John is rushing down the pane. James is going slow again. James has met a sort of smear. John is getting very near. Is he going fast enough? James has found a piece of fluff. John has hurried quickly by. James was talking to a fly. John is there, and John has won. Look, I told you. Here's the sun. Fingerprint powder. Those tracks look like the letter W. They must have been made by a woozle. Bubble pipe. Those are circles.
That was some super duper doing. You finished some more games, so now you get to add some more sounds to make your personalized, one-of-a-kind doorbell even more personal and more one-of-a-kindish.
Just click on your contraption whenever you'd like to change the sounds it makes. Welcome, Matt.
What time is it? What time is it?
Where am I going? I don't quite know. Down to the stream where the kingcups grow. Up on the hill where the pine trees blow. Anywhere, anywhere. I don't know. Where am I going? The clouds sail by. Little ones, baby ones, over the sky. Where am I going? The shadows pass. Little ones, baby ones, over
now,
the
if
grass.
You just click on this.
If you were a cloud and sailed up there, you'd sail on water as blue as air. And you'd see me here in the fields and say, doesn't the sky look green today? Where am I going? The high rooks call. It's awful fun to be born at all. Where am I going? The ring doves coo. We do have beautiful things to do. If you were a bird and lived on high, you'd lean on the wind when the wind came by. You'd say to the wind when it took you away, that's where I wanted to go today. Where am I going? I don't quite know. What does it matter where people go? Down to the wood where the bluebells grow. Anywhere, anywhere. I don't know. A lion has a tail, and a very fine tail. And so has an elephant, and so has a whale. And so has a crocodile, and so has a quail. They've all got tails but me. If I had sixpence, I would buy one. I'd say to the shopman, let me try one. I'd say to the elephant, this is my one. They'd all come round to see. Then I'd say to the lion, why, you've got a tail, and so has the elephant, and so has the whale. And look, there's a crocodile. He's got a tail. You've all got tails, like me. No one can tell me. Nobody knows where the wind comes from, where the wind goes. It's flying from somewhere, as fast as it can. I couldn't keep up with it, not if I ran. But if I stopped holding the string of my kite, it would blow with the wind for a day and a night. And then, when I found it, wherever it blew, I should know that the wind had been going there too. So then I could tell them where the wind goes. But where the wind comes from, nobody knows. Oh, the magnifying glass makes things look bigger. There are lions and roaring tigers and enormous camels and things. There are buffalo bisons and a great big bear with wings. There's a sort of a tiny potamus and a tiny rhinoceros too. But I gave buns to the elephant when I went down to the zoo. There are badgers and bidgers and bodgers and a superintendent's house. There are masses of notes.
If you just click on this little arrow, you can hear the rest of the poem.
And I think there's a sort of something, which is called a wallaboo. But I gave buns to the elephant when I went down to the zoo. If you try to talk to the bison, he never quite understands. You can't shake hands with a mingo. He doesn't like shaking hands. And lions and roaring tigers hate saying, how do you do? But I give buns to the elephant when I go down to the zoo. I often wish I were a king, and then I could do anything. If only I were king of Spain, I'd take my hat off in the rain. If only I were king of France, I wouldn't brush my hair for aunts. I think if I were king of Greece, I'd push things off the mantelpiece. If I were king of Norway, I'd ask an elephant to stay. If I were king of Babylon, I'd leave my button gloves undone. If I were king of Timbuktu, I'd think of lovely things to do. If I were king of anything, I'd tell the soldiers, I'm the king. James, James, Morrison, Morrison, Weatherby, George, Dupree, took great care of his mother, though he was only three. James, James, said to his mother, mother, he said he, you must never go down to the end of the town if you don't go down with me. James, James, Morrison's mother, put on a golden gown. James, James, Morrison's mother, drove to the end of the town. James, James, Morrison's mother, said to herself, said she, I can get right down to the end of the town and be back in time for tea. King John put up a notice. Lost or stolen or strayed. James, James, Morrison's mother, seems to have been mislaid. Last seen wandering vaguely, quite of her own accord. She tried to get down to the end of the town. 40 shillings reward. James, James, Morrison, Morrison, commonly known as Jim, told his other relations not to go blaming him. James, James, said to his mother, mother, he said he, you must never go down to the end of the town without consulting me. James, James, Morrison's mother, hasn't been heard of since. King John said he was sorry, so did the queen and prince. King John, somebody told me, said to a man he knew, if people go down to the end of the town, well, what can anyone do? J-J-M-M-W-G-D-O-P took great CO his M, though he was only three. J-J said to his M, M, he said he, you must never go down to the end of the town if you don't go down with me.
Now, whenever you want to see if you're home, just ring the old doorbell that you yourself made.
Well, that wraps up this gameplay of Winnie the Pooh. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you did. Comment down below sharing your thoughts and subscribe for more nostalgic gaming. Remember, you are all special and loved. You are never alone and you're always welcome to come hang out. Until the next video, God bless. I'll see you all later. Bye-bye, everyone.
This, I'm sorry. Are you most certainly certain you must go? I shall simply say a simple good day, for when you're of a mind to play again, the Hundred Acre Wood will always be here, and will always be waiting just for you.